But there's just no way in hell her character would ever do that.
Who cares? It was funny.
Mm-mm. It was cockamamie.
I'm sorry, no one uses that word anymore.
Mm-hmm. Well, it's the only word I know that accurately describes every romantic comedy in history. There's always some fake reason the stars can't be together when you know they're gonna be together from the poster. It's like, oh, boo-hoo, I'm so heartbroken. Even though you're perfect for me, I'm taking a break from dating. I mean, no one is ever taking a break from dating. And let me tell you, if Ryan Gosling waltzed in here, picked me up, and floated me around the room to the theme of Dirty Dancing, I'm not gonna be like, oh, hey, Ryan, buddy, bad timing. I'm taking a break from dating. I am jumping on that train, the Ryan Gosling train.
I'd jump on the Ryan Gosling train. So who was this dickhead that ruined romantic comedies for you?
I'd rather not go there.
Come on, we're already here.
What's his name? Bill? Fred? Carlos? Juan? Bob?
Luke.
Oh, he sounds like a wanker.
No. He was handsome, smart, French. He wore these sexy little John Lennon glasses. He did triathlons. Man, he had stamina.
So what happened?
Nothing much. We just wanted different things. I wanted someone to take home for the holidays, and he wanted to text photos of his cock to the girl that made his double macchiato. So,
ouch.
Well, it was my fault. He was too hot to be trustworthy. Always date down. That's what my sister says. I didn't listen. I gotta pee.
Thanks for watching. Subscribe to the Netflix Film Club channel to get our latest exclusive videos. Plus, hit the bell so you don't miss a single one.